Good morning, dear student. This is class 11th and I am Anjali Singh. Now, the study we discussed about linear displacement as well as, you know, relation between them. Today we are going to discuss about angular velocity. Today's topic is angular velocity. So, what is this angular velocity? Angular velocity is the ratio of angular displacement to the time taken. How much? As I told you, velocity is the rate of change of displacement upon time. Here angle is here. Here also displacement is there. Here also displacement is there. But the displacement regarding to the displacement regarding with the angle. So here angle I have given theta as well as change in angle, that is del theta. Clear, student? So what is this angular velocity? Rate of change of angular displacement. Rate of change of angular displacement. I think this you had learned in class 9. Rate means time. Okay, rate means time. Rate of change of angular displacement with respect to time will tell you about the angular velocity. So, here whatsoever theory is there, I'll tell you. Here, an object is kept at point A. An object is kept at point A in the x-axis at the time 0. Yahan par time kitna hai? 0. Now, the angle start displace. Now, the angle start displacing from point A to B. Okay, from point A to B with an angle. So, with an angle, that angle is theta. That angle is theta. It displaces with the angle theta with the time t. Okay, with the time t. Here time will be taken. With the time t. Here the time is 0. It displaces with the time t. With an angle theta. Now again, the body is displaced from point B to point C. With an angle theta plus del theta, okay, and with the time t plus del t. Clear, student? Time also changes with an angle, okay, and the angle is theta plus del theta. Now, what is angular velocity? The formula of angular velocity, actually it is this angular velocity shown by omega. This angular velocity is shown by omega. Now, rate of change of angular displacement. Angular displacement is changing like theta plus del theta minus theta. This much changes is there. This is the change of angular displacement. And the time changes is del t plus t. Okay, t plus del t is remaining same. Now, it is changes through t. Okay, so angular velocity is equals to del theta by del t. Clear, student? Del theta by del t. Okay, you got the value. Now, this is what? This value, what is the SI unit is? Radian per second. SI unit of this is important. Okay, SI unit is radian per second. SI unit of this is radian per second and it's a scalar quantity. It's a scalar quantity. Dear children, this is a scalar quantity. Okay, now what is it? Instantaneous angular velocity. Instantaneous angular velocity. What is this? Instantaneous angular velocity. What is that? Okay, it is also a new term for you. Instantaneous angular velocity. Instantaneous angular, instantaneous means at a particular instant of time. Suppose I tell you this object is traveled with 3 km at 2 a.m. At 2 a.m. means the particular at a particular time the object is traveled with this speed. Okay, student? So instantaneous angular velocity means the velocity at a particular time. Okay, so here it tends to always t tends to 0. Always t tends to 0. Clear, student? Always here always here t tends to 0. Okay, yeah, always t tends to 0. Now I have the value is del theta by del t. Always rate of change of time will be 0 in case of instantaneous angular velocity. Clear student? कैसे पता चलेगा कि instantaneous angular velocity है? तो क्या करना पड़ेगा? Rate of change of time at a particular instant of time will be 0. Clear student? I think now you got the value of this. Okay, now here I am going to write it with the angle del theta by del t. Clear? Del theta by del t. This is, please student, copy it please. Okay, copy it student. Now I am going to rub it. Now our second topic is, okay, I will take my second topic from here. I have to take only one value from there, otherwise everything is going to be same. Okay, this is not tough. Now what is our second topic? Our second topic is relation between angular velocity and linear velocity. Okay, relation between angular velocity and linear velocity. Angular and linear velocity. Okay, children, angular and linear velocity. So for that, I have, yes, first I'll tell you what is linear velocity. Okay, linear velocity. And linear velocity, you know, what is that? Linear velocity, you know, what is that? Here we have to take one value, okay? Angular and linear velocity. For that, I am again going to make a diagram. This diagram is like this, okay? It is as same as that. This distance is r, okay? And this is del r, this is theta, okay? And this is r plus del r. Clear, student? R plus del r. Okay, now this is O. We are going to take with the vector. Okay, now what is the value of all this? Del theta, sorry, this rate of change of angle change हो रहा है. Now यहाँ पर हम क्या यूज करेंगे? We have to use the value. First, what is the value of angular velocity? Omega is equals to del theta by del t. याद है सबको? Omega is equals to del theta by del t. यहाँ पर आप सबको पता है डिस्टेंस है r. Okay, O A O B. Okay, name also I have provided. O A and this is O B. Position vector. Position vector means how much position can change from after this. Okay, so this is going to multiply it. So del theta is equals to omega del t. First, okay, omega del t. Now what we have to do? Okay, so yes, now again we have to find the value of del theta through this diagram. What is the value of del theta? Del theta tells you about the position vector. Okay, it tells you about the position. So what is the position? That is AB by OB. How much position covered? पहले तो r था, after that it is, now little bit radius got changed. This is radius, so radius got changed. Okay, so यहाँ क्या हो जाएगा? Del theta is equals to AB की जगह del r by r. Clear student? Del r by r. Now yes, now अब हम क्या कर देंगे? Del r is equals to del theta into r. Clear class? देखिए इसको, please see this. Now can I put the value? Del r is equals to, in place of del theta मैं क्या लिखूंगी? Omega del t r. ओमेगा डेल टी आर, इसको ट्रांसफर कर देते हैं, डेल आर बाय डेल टी इज इक्वल्स टू ओमेगा आर. क्लियर स्टूडेंट? एंड यू नो रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट टू द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ टाइम, रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट टू द रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ टाइम, दिस आई एम गोइंग टू राइट हियर. Rate of change of displacement to the rate of change of displacement, that is equal to velocity. That is equal to velocity. So here v is equals to omega r. Now my last expression is that I have to write it in the form of vector. In the form of vector, you know which type of vector will be there? Yes. Which type of vector means which type of product we are going to use it, which is here perpendicular is there, so E is equals to V is equals to omega cross R. This is my final expression, and this expression tells you the relation between the linear velocity and angular velocity. Today we read about angular velocity, and our next topic is relation between and angular velocity. Clear student? So this is your last expression. Please do it, revise it. Before that, what we read about the displacement, this time we read about the velocity. Next we will read about the acceleration. Okay, that will be on, that I will take on tomorrow. So please revise it, and this is all for today's video. Thank you.